ए स्क्वायर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन इंटू एक्स प्लस ए. सो सी हियर समटाइम्स द ग्रुपिंग हैज बीन डन रॉन्ग. ओके एज यू कैन सी हियर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन इंटू एक्स और कैन यू ग्रुप दीज टू. इज इट पॉसिबल टू ग्रुप दीज टू. If you group these two, what will be the common? A? What inside are you?
A so plus L.
There is no need to expand this one, okay? Like in earlier question, if grouping has been done wrong, we used to?
A squared. Cross.
So if we write it like this, A square X square plus A X square plus 1 into X. Okay, what is common here? A X square. Plus 1 into A plus AX square plus 1 into A. Okay, now you can take out the common AX square plus 1 and here is X A plus X. Are you all getting the same? Have you got the same answer?
Yes.
So always check whether the grouping has been done wrong or not. So here, these two terms have been combined and it was correct. Okay. Sometimes they group them wrong. Okay. Try next one. Everyone try next one. Two a minus b minus ten a plus b. Okay, so you can check if you can find common between these and these. It's fine. If not, then you have to expand this one. Okay. So once check whether do you have common anything common. If you take five out. Last two terms, if you take 5 out, minus 5 you have taken out. So what will be inside 2a and minus you already taken. So it will be minus b. Now you can see there is a common between them and you can take out. Keep doing the questions. Today we have to complete this exercise and next time onwards we will start the trinomial. Okay. So next time onwards there will be homework as well. Two a minus b minus 5. Two a minus b we have taken common out. What is remaining? 1 2 a minus b is remaining. 10 minus 5. Everyone try next one. Next one, all you all can do.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, so this last step I not done this one.
Here. Okay. See here. So, what is here? It's 2a minus b the whole square. So it's like this. We can write it like this or not. Minus 5, 2a minus b. Now, take 2a minus b common. So 2a minus b, we have taken common out. 1 2a minus b already gone. It is gone. So what is remaining? 2a minus b minus 5. So we can write straight from here. 2a minus b square. It means 2a minus b into 2a minus b is there. And take 2a minus b as common. This common between them. 2a minus b. Take it out. What is remaining? 2a minus b minus 5. Understood? Try next one.
Yes, sir.
Everyone try next one. Next one as well, simple.
So, but in last one, 3 are common. So, sir, how? Second blank 2a minus b minus 5 form.
Okay, how it is so? Okay, tell me how you take common. If I'm writing x square minus x.
So
you take x common up. Outside. What is remaining now?
1.
X minus 1. Okay, if I write like this, x plus 3 plus 2x plus 6. Okay. One minute. X square 3x. Okay. And here square. Okay. Now tell me how you are going to take. If you take
x square outside.
X square plus x square common outside. X plus 3 plus 2 x plus 3. You are taking x plus 3 outside common. What is remaining? X square plus 2 will remain. Similarly, we are doing here. We are taking this common outside. So what is remaining? 2a minus b minus 5. Now see if you expand this one again. 4 times. Just multiply it. How you are going to do it? 2a minus b. Consider this as one term. This whole is what now into 2a minus b. Now minus sign will be there. 5 into 2a minus b. Yes or no? If you are multiplying them, you are going to take get this one.
That these 3 2a minus b, all the 3 are equal, so we can take all the 3 as our common.
How can you take 3 common? See here. Here x square and x. Both are x in terms of x only, no? But we can take only one x outside. Yes or no? Okay, if I'm writing 2a minus b square minus 2a minus b, what will be the common between them? Two a minus b is common, so 2a minus b we have taken out. Okay, now 2a minus b is remaining. Here 1, 2a and minus 1 will be here. Consider x equal to 2a minus b. Isn't same like? Aren't both same like? If x equal to 2a minus b, whole square minus 2a minus b. So from here and here, 2a minus b is common. We have taken the 2a minus b outside. Now what is remaining? 2a minus b is here, minus 1. It's same like this only. X square minus x, what is common between them? It is x into x minus x. It's x into x minus x. So 1x we have taken out. What is remaining? X minus 1. Similarly, here 2a minus b we have taken out. What is remaining? 2a minus b still is there. It's square. So 2a minus b is there. Now minus 1.
I understand.
Here, okay, here is 5. So you can consider this whole as x. Okay. Try next one. Have you got the next one? So after your examination, as you get the holiday, please complete this exercise at least, okay? A into A minus 4. Minus a plus 4. Okay. So you can easily get the common. If you take a into a minus 4 minus a minus 4. Now see, we are considering this a minus 4 as one term. A minus 4 here, a minus 4 multiplied with a. This is one term, this is the other term. What is common between them? A minus 4. It is same like numbers you do, like 12. Plus 6 is there. What is common 6? 2 plus 1. Similarly, these are nothing but numbers only. So whatever is applicable on numbers, everything will be applicable on there. If I'm writing 6 square minus 6. 1, 6 we outside. 6 minus 1. So what is common? A minus 4. And what is remaining? A minus 1. Okay. Try next one. Y square minus A plus. Here you have to check. Y square minus A plus B Y plus AB. Are you able to form grouping of these two? Will you get any common if you group these two? Or you have to do something else here? Will you be able to group them? So it means these two terms have been grouped wrongly, AY plus BY. So we have to, again, you have to multiply them. Y square minus, what it will be? AY minus BY plus AB. Now group them. Which two term you should group? Either these two or these two. First and second. First, second, third, fourth. Either you can group first and second, third and fourth, or first and third, second and fourth. So it means earlier these two terms were grouped, that was wrong. Second and third grouping was wrong. So we have to go Y, what will be here? Y minus A. And if I take minus B outside, what will be here? Y minus A. This time, what is common between these two terms? Y minus A into Y minus B. Understood? Try next one. Everyone, try next one. You remember the expansion? We have done this one. Try next one. A square plus 1 upon A square minus 2 minus 3 A plus 1 upon 3 A. Okay. So if I don't write it, can you find something?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, you written wrong.
Plus 3 upon A is there. At last.
Plus 3, yes, 3 upon A, yes, it should be 3 upon A. Yes, if I skip this one, so can you figure out what's here? What's this? It's expansion of some
minus 1 upon A whole
square. A minus 1 upon A the whole square. A minus 1 upon A the whole square. And here as well, are you getting something? If you take minus 3 outside, A minus 1 upon A, are you? So if we see this one, it's an expansion of A minus 1 upon A, the whole square. It's expansion of A minus 1 upon A, the whole square. This you already have studied. Okay. Now take minus 3 outside. What is remaining inside? A minus 1 upon A. Now what's common here? A minus 1 upon A. One of the is square, it means A minus 1 upon A into A minus 1 upon A. So one of them we have taken outside. What will remain inside? A minus 1 upon A is here. And here what will be there? Minus 3. Have you understood this one?
Yes, sir.
One A minus 1 upon A we have taken outside. Still one is remaining. And here minus 3 is remaining. This one. Okay. Try next one. Try next one. Try to figure out, is there some identity involved here? Try to figure out the identity if it is involved there. Okay, if we rearrange the terms, can you get something, some identity? If I
write plus y.
X square plus y square plus x plus y. Either you can write this first or this afterwards, this up to you. So what is this identity?
X plus
y the whole square plus x plus y. Now you can easily get common out. So x plus y is common here. X plus y into x plus y it is. So x plus y, one of them we have taken outside. What is remaining inside? X plus y plus 1. X plus y plus 1. Understood? Okay, try next one. Try next one. As well, try to find out the identity involved here. Rearrange the terms. Rearrange the terms. A square plus 4b square. Minus 3a. Minus of plus. Minus 4b. Okay. Can you figure out something? If we rearrange it, a square plus 4b square. Minus 4ab, minus 3a,
plus 6b.
See, if you take minus 3 outside, it will be a minus 2b. And whose square is this one?
Sir, a minus 2b.
A minus 2b. You can see a square plus 2b the whole square. So it is a, and here minus 4ab. Minus, so see here, a minus 2b the whole square. A square plus 2b the whole square minus 2a into 2b minus 4ab. So it is a minus 2b the whole square minus 3 common out a minus 2b. Now, what's common between these two terms? A minus 2b and here a minus 2b minus 3. Understood? Okay, everyone try next one. Should we multiply them or we can easily find out the common? Check in that. Everyone try next one. Mx minus 3y. The whole square plus n plus 5x.
Sir?
Yes, sorry.
Sir, it is 3y minus x. Sir, for n.
N, it is 3y minus x. Okay. 3y minus x. Okay, have you got the hint here? 3y?
Yes, sir.
Minus x, okay? So how are you going to proceed next? Sorry. X minus 3y, 3 minus x. You have 5x minus 15. If you take 5 outside, x minus 3y. X minus 3y. What should we do here?
Sir, we can interchange the digits.
We can put negative sign here and we can invert them like negative. Okay. So next one, m x minus 3y the whole square minus n, it will be x minus 3y. Yes or no? Minus 3y plus x plus 5 x minus 3y. Now take the common out. What is remaining? That we can put x minus 3y common. What will remain here? M into M will be here. X minus 3y will be here. Oh, still one is here. Minus N plus 5. Will it be the answer? Or you can distribute that, multiply that. Okay. That will be the answer. X minus 3y. One factor, other factor MX minus 3MY. Minus N plus 5. These will be the factors. Okay. Try next one. Everyone try next one. X 6 minus 5y minus 4. 6 minus. It's easy. Try the next one. You can easily figure out. x, 6x minus 5y, minus 4, 6x minus 5y, the whole square. You can easily get 6x minus 5, 6x minus 5, 6x minus 5 common. What will be here? X minus 4 into 6x minus 5y. Either curly bracket or square bracket, that's up to you. Open the bracket and solve it. Four six, 24x plus 20y. So you can write minus 23x plus 20y. Have you all understood?
Yes,
have
sir.
Have you all got the same answer? Okay. Now let's discuss trinomials. So see here, till now what was given? If anything is common between all them, take it out. If anything is common between all the terms, first check, is there anything common? Take that out first. Okay. Now, whatever remaining, try to group them. Try to group them so that we may have something common. Then take it out again, go to the first one. So mainly these all are applicable for even number of terms. When we are having even number of terms. Okay, what if we have trinomial, that is three number of terms. If we are having three number of terms, three terms are there. So an algebraic expression having three terms is called as trinomial. So we'll be solving a trinomial. So first of all, here the expression will be in this form. A x square plus bx plus c. This will be our expression, okay? A x square plus bx plus c. So we can have plus or minus, we can have plus or minus. This will be our expression, and we have to solve. So how many terms are there? First, second, third. You can see x square, x, then x is for zero. So I dig highest, lower, then where it is in descending order, powers. X square, x, c. So how we can solve this one? How to factorize this one? So it's three terms. So till now we have discussed first common term. That is anything common we can take out. Next we have discussed grouping, and then again after grouping taking common out. Yes or no? This we have done. Now what you are going to do, if trinomial is there, trinomial first. So see here, mainly grouping is done when even number of terms are there. So trinomial will make even number of terms, and then again go for grouping, taking common out. Okay, this way we are going to do trinomial. It means it's three terms, we have to make it in four terms. We have to make four terms out of these three terms. How we are going to do that? So take the middle term and split it. That is something plus something. In this fashion, we'll split the middle term. We are going to split the middle term. Understood? That is first term is here, last term. Middle term we will split in such fashion that is something common adjust between these two terms and then these two terms, okay? And further we are going to solve. So trinomial, make even number of terms. Even number of terms we got, now grouping, taking common out, this fashion again will follow. Understood? Okay, I'm giving one question. Try this one. X square plus 5x plus 6. So how to solve this one? We have to middle term, we have to split. So how we can split the middle term? So see here, we have to find two such terms. If we multiply them, it must come how much? 6. That is 6 into, what is the quotient here? 1? So 6 into 1, that should be the product. Okay, next, second, and their sum should be 5. This middle term 5 will split. How to split? Such that their product is 6. 6 into 1. There should be product. What should be the sum? 5. So find those two terms. It's easy. Factorize this one. What you're going to get? 3 into 2. 3 into 2 is the factorization. Okay. Now, see here. Product is positive. Sum is positive. It means both the terms are positive or not. If product is positive, yes, as well as the sum is positive, it means both the terms are positive. So find two positive terms whose product is 6 and sum is 5. Which two terms? Just so factorize this one.
2 and 3.
2 and 3. Either you write 3 and 2, 2 and 3, it's fine. Yes or no? You can write this equation as x square. Now split this one. 3x plus 2x plus 6 you can write. Or you can write x square plus 2x plus 3x plus 6. It doesn't matter. Both you are getting, you'll be getting the answer. Understood? Now we have split it into four terms. We have split it into four terms. Now group them. Now the same fashion what we have been doing till now. So first two terms if we group, x plus 3 plus 2, x plus 3. Now taking common out, x plus 3, x plus 2. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what if here minus is there? Try this one. If it is minus here. So we need to find two terms whose product is 6 and sum is negative. That is, if we are adding them, we are getting minus 5. It means, see here, product is 6. It means both the terms can be either positive, positive, or both the terms can be negative or negative. Have you understood this one? Both the terms, product is 6, means both the terms should be positive, or both the terms should be negative. Since sum is negative, it means both the terms are negative. Only this can be true. Since product of two terms is 6, positive, it means both the terms, either they can be positive or negative. Since sum is negative, it means which is possible from it? First one. So both the terms are negative. This time, minus 3 and 2, or minus 2 and minus 3. So it will be how much? X square minus 3x minus 2x plus 6. Take x outside, x minus 3. Minus 2, x minus 3. Further you can do x minus 3 into x minus 2. Understood? Okay. Try next one. What if we have both negative? Product is negative. Then, and product is negative, it means one of the term is positive, other term is negative. Yes or no? One of the term is positive, other term is negative. Okay, so find two terms. See here, 6 if we factorize, it can be minus sign 4 times being 4 gets 6 into 1 or 3 into 2. Either of them will be true. So see here, product is negative. It means one term is positive, other term is negative. Okay. Now, sum is negative. It means which term is bigger? Negative term is bigger. Negative term will be bigger and positive term will be smaller. Then only we are going to get the minus 5. So 6 into 1, minus 6 and 1. Product is minus 6. Sum is plus 1, minus 6. Minus 5. Understood this one? So this time x square plus x minus 6x minus 6. Take common. You can write 6x. You can also write it like this. X square minus 6x plus x minus 6. This way as well, you are going to get the same answer. X common, x plus 1, minus 6 common, x plus 1. Okay. X plus 1 into x plus 6. Have you understood?
Yes.
Okay. What if here we have plus, then? If we have the plus sign, then? It means? Their product is negative, but their sum is plus. So if product is negative, means one is positive term, other is negative term. Okay, the sum is five, that is positive, means which is bigger? Positive term is bigger.
It means
positive is bigger. Six and minus one. So this time x square plus 6x minus x minus x. You can write them in any order. First this one or this one, it doesn't matter. X common, x plus 6, minus x plus 6. Minus sign, minus 1 we have taken out. So x plus 6 into x minus 1. Okay. Have you understood? So fifth B.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Fifth B, try those questions, okay? Up to 6. As homework during holidays. You do it, okay? If you get the holidays, do, okay? Afterwards, you do. Not these days. So, sixth question, see here, what you're going to apply first. Sixth question, just see once. 24a cube plus 37a square minus 5a. So, what first you have to check? Whether if there is anything common between all the terms. Among all the terms. If it is, take that out. So, what you're going to take out first? Okay, here we have, okay, up to 4 only you try. Up to 4 only you try. Okay. Try once, we see that. Okay. Anything you want to ask? So just try those 4 questions. We're starting next time whenever we meet. Anything you want to ask? Okay, you all have to attend the examination. Okay. And do check whether your CSoft is working or not. Anything else is not working. For CSoft, you have to contact the school immediately. Okay. If it's not working, contact school immediately. And school code is, yes, RA010. Okay, always remember this code is there. Yes.
5 minutes of, five minutes of the exam. CSoft when we open before 5 minutes of the exam. So it is, yes, not working.
It doesn't work sometimes. Okay.
And so sometimes if we not open the link before 5 minutes, before 10 minutes, after 5 minutes it won't open.
The link will open, but see, there's some issues with CSoft. Usually it doesn't work. So see, yeah, mainly it will be uploaded 15 minutes earlier. So you can do one thing. CSoft is okay. It's open in browser, then you can copy the link. If you're using desktop, it's easy. Copy the link and keep it there, okay? But my paper will be available in channel as well, okay? But CSoft, like last time I have seen as well, I used my CSoft. It doesn't work 2 or 3 minutes earlier than paper. And at the same time, sometimes it starts or not, okay? It happens, okay?
So then if we tell teachers, some teachers will send the link on WhatsApp, but some teachers said that contact the school link.
Here mainly some issues are there with CSoft. It means at that time all are assessing, so it doesn't work.